Hi, I'm Alejandro Hoyos, and today we're here at Berlin for the launch of Intel's Core Ultra Series 2, also known as Lunar Lake. And we're going to be taking a closer look here at AI, and today with us we have Craig. Hey Craig, how's it going?
Hey, it's going. Always a pleasure to be with you, Alex.
Yeah, it's also great to be here. So tell us, what do we have here?
Oh my gosh, well this is our brand new program. Let me introduce you to AI Playground. And for all the AI PCs that we have out there flooding to the market, as well as some of our brand new Intel Core Ultra series, the second series for codename Lunar Lake, we're actually launching for our integrated graphics a way to go ahead and use all of those amazing AI features locally on your machine and for free, all in the same place in this AI Playground application, which is something that you guys can download today. But let me go ahead and give you a couple examples of how it works.
So, sure.
Alex, just really quickly, you know, for one of the things that we get all the time is, how do I use this stuff? And usually some of the most simple implementations that we have are actually up in the cloud, but sometimes they require obviously a connection, I have to share some data, and in some cases I have to pay for a service, whether it's per instance or I'm paying a monthly service to get this access. Well, something like this, I can use an AI Playground, and if I wanted to go ahead and generate a picture, well, let's say of flying corgis in this case, well, I can go ahead and bring them up and it's gonna go ahead and pop three quick ones out of there, and that's all happening on this Intel Core Ultra Series 2 machine that we have right here. No internet connection required, and it was able to pump out those four pictures all by harnessing really the power of our next generation Arc XE graphics, second generation.
That's pretty impressive. So we're just using all the, well, we can use the different engines, but this one is using the graphics engines, right?
Yep, that's absolutely correct. And so this one, we want to get the fastest generation possible, but this allows us to not only do stable diffusion like we're doing here, but download multiple models that we can use interchangeably for these features. So want to use a different model for your AI generation? Go ahead and bring it down. Intel will curate those for you, or you can actually, outside of the list that you can select from, you can grab it from anything on Hugging Face that you want to do to be able to bring it down. But here's also another cool feature, which is, well, in the same application, we can go over here to Answer, which is now we're using all of the popular LLM functionality that you've seen. You wanted to go ahead and take advantage of all those amazing ChatGPT things that we are so used to using online. Well, now you can have that on your own PC, privately away from the cloud, and be able to do some amazing stuff like, well, let's go ahead and do some coding. And here I'm actually using a Phi-3 model, but I can pick from any of these models that I have here readily and available, or even download my own based on its own function. And so let's go ahead and generate with Phi-3, we're gonna go ahead and make a quick game in Python. So as a budding coder myself, this makes it really, really easy to put together a quick example of, let me try and see how AI is doing for me. And this is a tool I always have in my bag. It looks like we're doing a text-based game on Guess the Number, but we can go ahead and expand this into anything that we wanna do, not by searching, but by asking and answering that we have right here in the playground. And so many more capabilities that will be able to be fit in here. And again, we want it to be, this is AI for everyone. And as the second generation, we have a brand new AI interface on here, and it's not just for discrete anymore. With this newest release that you'll see in the next couple of days, we will have all our iGPU on this next generation of Arc graphics. You'll be able to use it on all your Intel AI PCs going forward, even the previous generation.
No, this is great because, I mean, for this, for example, it's a great tool for learning. I mean, it's not only to explore, but also if you're learning how to code Python, like it'd be a great example of how to do that.
Oh, yeah. I mean, and also we have some advanced features in here as well. So if you want to teach an existing model new tricks, I can go ahead and upload my own personal files to it. So if I want to enable the query here, and it's going to go ahead and use a technology called RAG, or Retrieval Augmented Generation, which means I can teach it my own skills. I take my own documents, and whatever is included in those documents, my AI now becomes an expert at. So if I wanted to go ahead and download some Lunar Lake facts that I have here, and then I can make it a basically any tech expert that I want to. If I download Catcher in the Rye, it's going to become a literary expert on that individual book, or literally the list goes on and on. And here's the best part, is that it keeps all of your information private because it never takes any of it to the web. So again, super powerful to use all of your AI usage models, super simple for anyone to use, and completely free. So go and get yourself a copy today.
Yeah, that's pretty amazing because you're actually training the model with the data that you have locally on your system.
Yeah.
And that way you can use, like, for example, like up to today, that was confidential information, but now you can have it there and like, okay, help me create all this messaging and all those different things.
That is correct. So whether it's your personal information or what we're using at work, you can be safe and secure that your data is really never going to leave your machine.
That's great. So if you're curious about experimenting with AI, this is a great
come on down. This is a great place to start. So give AI Playground a try, downloadable today.
Thank you, Craig. Appreciate it, man.
Thank you.
Thanks.